Hi everyone. Today I want to share with you how to plant dahlias. And dahlias are spectacular summer blooming flowers that bloom nonstop, midsummer all the way through fall. They come in dozens of different colors, forms, heights, and bloom sizes. And they're the perfect flower to keep your garden looking great all the way until the first frost. Dahlias can be grown in hardiness zones 3 through 11, and in zones 8 through 11, they can be left in the garden year round. They're sold as tubers, either a single tuber or as a clump of tubers around a stem. And the size and shape of the tuber will vary widely depending on the dahlia variety. So don't worry when you see one dahlia that's very small and one that's very large, one that's more plump and one that's more long and narrow. This doesn't determine the plant success. Rather, it's important that a dahlia have all three parts. First, we have the body, which is the food storage, the eye, which will sprout and become the stalk of the new plant, and then we need a sturdy, unbroken neck that connects the other two parts. Now, don't be concerned if a clump of tubers has some broken or loose tubers. It only takes one good eye that's connected to the neck and body to produce a healthy plant with loads of flowers. Dahlias are really cold sensitive, and they shouldn't be planted out into the garden until all danger of frost has passed and the soil has warmed to at least 60 degrees Fahrenheit. And if you live in a colder climate, you can get a jump start on the season by planting up your dahlia tubers inside. Dahlias need full sun and rich, loose, well-draining soil to put on their best floral show for you. So before planting, add a generous 2 to 3 inch layer of compost into the planting area. Next, dig a hole that's 4 to 6 inches deep and place the tuber in the hole with the eye of the tuber facing upwards, and then cover it with soil. Now, if you're growing a variety of dahlia that will reach heights of 3 feet or taller, you want to go ahead and stake those plants at planting time. That way you can tie them to the stake as they grow. Some dahlias can even reach heights of 6 feet with huge dinner plate size blooms, so staking from the start is really crucial. Place a strong 5 to 6 foot stake near the tuber, and as the plant grows, use twine to tie the stems to the stake every 12 to 18 inches. Now, I know it might sound strange, but don't water your tubers upon planting. At this time, the tubers have no roots to receive excess moisture. So if we give them a lot of water upon planting, they might end up rotting there in the garden before they're able to sprout and grow roots. Now, of course, don't worry if it rains, but what I'm saying here is no excess moisture is necessary until you see green sprouts appear from the ground. And depending on what variety of dahlia you're growing and the growing conditions that they're in, sprouting time can vary between just a few weeks to a full month. That's completely normal. Now, once you see green growth emerge, you can start to water your dahlias. Give them a weekly soak of 1 to 2 inches of water if the weather does not provide it naturally. In the extreme heat of summer, bi-weekly watering may be necessary. Watering needs will vary based on location, weather, and soil. To encourage more branching and therefore more blooms on your dahlia, you can pinch them. Once the plants have 3 to 4 sets of leaves, snip the top of the plant off, right above a set of leaves. This pinch will cause the plant to send up multiple stems from below the cut, which will result in more flowering stems and a bushier plant. Now, once midsummer arrives, your dahlias will be in full glorious bloom. Keep them producing loads of flowers by deadheading spent blooms regularly, or cut bunches of blooms to bring inside and enjoy. Dahlias are truly a cut and come again flower. The more you cut, the more they come. Well, I sure hope this video on how to plant dahlias was helpful. And from all of us here at Longfield Gardens, happy gardening. Bye.